it's me. You mind if I stop in for a few? All right, thanks. How you been? It's good to see you. You mind if I pull up a seat? Have you been? Yeah. Same old, huh? Hey, looking good. You been holding up? Yeah, it's been a while since I got a chance to talk, check up on you, so I just thought I'd stop by if you don't mind. Cool. I brought a little something to drink. Care for some? Okay. Skull splitter. 5,000 years in the making. The Orkney Brewery. Quilu. Quilloo. The authentic Orcadian ale. A rich, sophisticated ale, satiny smooth, with deceptively light character. 8.5% alcohol by volume. You ever heard of this one? The first time I heard of it. Says here on the back, Skull Splitter takes its name from Thorfinn Hauskulluf, Hauskulluif, the seventh Viking Earl of Orkney. Sophisticated, satiny smooth, with a deceptively light character, is a tribute to our colorful forebear. And it goes on to say, on the nose, this robust beer has a fruity malt character, with hints of dark fruits, spicy hop, dates, and figs. On the palate, the sweet toasted malt creates a rich and complex character of molasses, fresh and dried fruits, with hints of warming spices. Looks like it's coming out of Scotland. Brewed in the UK, imported by St. Killian Importing Company, Inc., Kingston, Massachusetts, I believe. Sinclair Breweries Limited. The Orkney Brewery, Quilu. Stromness, Orkney, Scotland. Sinclairbreweries.co.uk. Found this just lying there like it was waiting for me. I just thought I'd pick it up and on my way over here. Hope you don't mind if I have a drink. Thanks, it's mighty kind. What's been new with you? Keys, yeah, keys. Sorry. Keys of a car I used to drive. My days gone by, right? Well, my friend, bottoms up. Wow. That is a nice ale. That's strong. Of malts. I can smell that fruity aroma. It's a nice beer. Nice ale, I guess, out of Scotland. Guess if I was to review this, if I was to be one of those beer review kind of guys, which I'm not really, I'd probably give this a 4. Of course, I'm mighty partial to ales like this. So how have you been? Times can be tough sometimes. We all have our ups and downs, our bumps and bruises, as they say. You know, we gotta try to do our best to get through those times. They're only temporary, you know. I'm no great philosopher by any means. I ain't no spiritual man. I just like to think I've got a little bit of notches in the belt, so to speak. Seen some things that ain't no body should see. How about you? Seen some things. Experienced some things. I'm sure you have. Mess with the mind. That's why it's good to talk. That's why I want to stop by, you know. It's been a while. And now they have you here on watch. I know how that can be. Gets a little bit lonely on the watch. What have you seen? Anything good? Yeah, stuff's not good. good for me, right? You know what's not good for me? People. People's not good for me. No, not you, not you. You know who I'm talking about. It's kind of people out there. Like to see you fail. Take pride in your misery. Smile at your face. And the minute you turn your back, that's when they drive the knife in. More worried about appearances. They keep you around as long as it serves them well. You know who I'm talking about. You know just who I'm talking about. They ain't too interested in you or me. Only if it helps them out. No, we're not going to waste our heat on those peeps. We're going to talk about all those good times. Have you ever been to the ocean? I was there when I was a little boy. My family. Family. Now there's a word. Family. Sometimes I find family in the company of strangers. In the moments passing, and all those years spent with my own family, my own kin, about you, about your family. Where do you come from, by the way? You got any brothers, sisters? Mom and dad, aunts, uncles, grandparents, any kids? Family. They like to feed us what family's supposed to be all about. Happy. Lots of siblings. Relatives, everybody's getting along. But they don't ever like to tell you about the dark side of the family. The abuse. All the pain and the hurt. Neglect. Yeah, we won't talk about that. We'll just sweep that under the carpet, right? Yeah. You experienced any of that? I mean, it's just me and you. You can be honest with me. I won't tell anybody. I was fortunate not to be abused, be molested. Others not so much. Have you ever been in a forest and just hear the calm? Right about now, this very moment. Warmth, the inner warmth. There is a find. You just have to give in to it and find it. It's right there, below the surface. It's peaceful and serene. It's always there. Just gotta slow down and sink into it. And you'll find a comfort there. But, as I was saying, family can be overrated. But it's not too important whether or not you have a perfect family. The family they want you to have, you see on TV or in the movies. All that matters is that you find your happiness, family or not. That's what's important. Out here, we ain't got nothing but each other. Out here, there ain't nothing that's gonna comfort us. It's gonna sink its talons into us. Tear us apart faster than it would ever think about embracing us. That's why you've gotta find whatever it is that's gonna make you happy. Right now. Not later. Not in the future. There is no future. There is no such thing as the future or the past. It's all just fabrication. There is only now. You know what scares me? I've never told anybody this before. You know what scares me? Not what's out there beyond that door. Ain't nothing. Not what's in my mind. Not what I'm capable of. Things I could do. Not any man, not any animal. What scares me is having to say goodbye. Having to say goodbye. Knowing that life, our life, my life, so short on this godforsaken rock. Having to say goodbye to those you know, those you love, those you may never know, those that you've cherished. You know, I got a son. I got a 6-year-old boy. I try to do my best by that boy. I do. I am not perfect. By no means. But that little boy, he keeps me from going over the edge, sinking into that dark abyss. And that's what I'm gonna miss when I say goodbye. It's either gonna be him going first, or me. And I pray it's me. Saying goodbye when I've only got to see if I'm lucky enough. If I'm lucky. Half of his life. If I live to be 80, 90 years old, I only have lived long enough to see half of his life. And that's what scares me. Never knowing what his accomplishments will be beyond that. Never being able to help him when he needs it. Beyond those days. And I can only hope that he'll have someone there for him. What scares you? You can tell me. You don't have to tell me right here. If you want to tell me later, if you want to write me a letter, go ahead. What scares you? That's what scares me. But we didn't come here so much to get all teary-eyed. It's a lot to live for. It's a lot to be happy about. There's a lot to be happy about, like right here, right now. You and me. Never got a chance to meet somebody like you before. So, I'm honored. Did I ever tell you a story about the rope walked into a bar? Goes up to the bartender, he says, "Hey, I'd like a drink." Bartender says, "We don't serve rope here." The rope is like, "What do you mean you don't serve rope here? Read the sign. We don't serve rope. We don't serve your kind." So the rope says, "Okay." Walks out of the bar, goes outside, messes up his hair, comes back in, bartender says, "Hey, didn't I just tell you, we don't serve rope here? Aren't you that guy I just told you not to come back here? That rope?" And the rope says, "Afraid not." Ba-dum-bum. I know. I shouldn't quit my day job. You know, when things get tough, be honest, there's not always going to be a light at the end of the tunnel. I had to tell that to Kevin. Poor Kevin. You don't know what happened to Kevin, do you? He was lying out there, his guts all over the cement. There's two walkers over him, shot him dead. He was still alive, poor son of a bitch. And we said, Kevin. He said, don't worry about me. He said, don't worry about me. He was a good boy. There's a lot of good men and women out there. Lost their lives for us. Some of them lost their minds. Fighting for what they thought was right. Even though we may not agree. This is for all those men and women who are fathers, mothers, sons and daughters, all sisters, brothers, aunts and uncles. One of these days we've got to learn to get our priorities straight. Life is not this. Life is not this. Life is not this. Life is not the things we own, things we know. Life is not money in the bank. Life is being able to live to our fullest. Yeah. Without any difficulty. We may have our physical ailments, our mental ailments, but beyond that, there should be nothing that should limit us, that should get in our way. Yet there is. We fight each other every day for what? We're all gonna get eaten by the same worm. We're all gonna lie in the cold, hard earth. None of us is going to meet any God. What's important is this planet. Without it, we wouldn't even be here. Now, there may be people that think that some God created us, and maybe he did. You're never going to know until the Pied Piper comes. And even if there was some God created us, created the earth, created great nature. Planted a seed from which we grew. It's nature that's important. You, that's important. It's us. And there'll be those that laugh. There'll be those that want to cement the earth. But when my time's over and I'm laying in the dirt, they'll be laying right next to me. Would all that money get you? Yeah, exactly. People don't get it. People don't get it. Certain things that are important in this world, it's not status. It's not a bank account. It's not your house. It's not my house. It's not your house. It's not my house. We all need to coexist. That's the only way we're gonna survive with each other. Gotta stop fighting. There's a bigger enemy out there. And one that has no conscience. It's Mother Nature. Mother Nature is your best friend, your lover. And she's also a terrorist. All those bombings, all the innocent lives killed, that's been going on a long time. Tsunami, volcanic eruption. You name it, tornado. Mother Nature will greet you in the morning with some sunshine and some blue skies. And then she'll turn your back on you quicker than you can say, shit. And she'll smack you upside your face. Nature is a woman scorned. I should know. Well, that was a good brew. Skull splitter. And my skull ain't quite split yet. So, but that's my opinion. You know, everybody has their own point of view. Everybody's scrambling around to make that mighty dollar. For what? For a legacy. A billion years from now, this rock's gonna die. Some point, sun's gonna die. It's gonna become a cold, hard place. Maybe some other kind of species will evolve. Right now, just imagine, instead of everybody spending time, and money, and resources on professional sports, on cars, gambling, on cigarettes, on alcohol, on toys, on video games, on music, on stocks. If we all stopped, say we all stopped for 1 year, and we realigned our efforts and our resources and focused. On rebuilding inner cities, poor neighborhoods. On building more housing for the homeless. On shortening the work day and the school day. Because ain't nobody work and learn a shit after 12 o'clock in the afternoon, let me tell you. What's more important is our health, our physical and mental health. That's more important. And each other. And this planet. What do you think about all that, huh? I'm sure you got your own point of view, and feel free to share that point of view, but just try to keep it civil. We don't need any more fighting around here. It's bad enough we got fighting outside on that door. They say all we need to do is get along. Can't we all get along? That's what I've been thinking about all along myself. Anyway. I talked your ear off. Seemed like it was me that needed a visit more than you. But I thank you kindly, either way. I gotta go out on a supply run. Gotta love them. Once you're feeling up to snuff, maybe I'll take you with me. Sound good? Show you around. Give you the lay of the land. Maybe even take you out target practice. Did you ever fire a gun before? Yeah, me neither. I like a nice axe or baseball bat. Besides, guns too noisy. All right, my friend. Best be on my way. Thanks for letting me stop by. If you ever need anything, just let me know. Try to stop by more frequently. Until next time, take care.